evening, troops, and welcome to another review. It's going to be Paul McCartney and Wings. Surprise, surprise. Had a little bit of bad news on the last video. It was, what was it called? Back to the Egg. Now, this bit was the last bit, which was the Wonderful Christmas Time song. And also Night Tonight was tagged on, but unfortunately YouTube, you know how strict they are these days, they found a copyright problem and they've muted it, everything, including my audio. So what I'm gonna do, if this kind of thing happens again, I shall go to the original file and I shall just upload the basic audio which I originally done. You know, because afterwards, I like to keep you people entertained. I go to a lot of effort, you know. I add things, you know, I add photographs, footage, you know, all kinds of wonderful things, you know, just to, because people mean a lot to me, you know. And anyway, listen, on to the album we're going to do today, and it's called, I don't want to waste too much time, but yeah, it's Red Rose Speedway. Now, I don't remember many people having a lot to say about this. I think Rock Boy was saying it was a brilliant undiscovered album. I could be wrong, but I disagree. This, at the very best, was tuning up for Band on the Run, which came out the same year. It was a very productive year for McCartney. In fact, he was helping everybody on their albums. Ringo, he helped brother Mike McCartney do this album, which forget it. I mean, he did a lot of stuff this year. And anyway, this, I've got 14 tracks on my particular CD here. I think the original album had something like 10 tracks, but more than 10, because there's this maybe one, maybe two dreadful medleys. We'll get to that, though. We'll get to that. Right, where shall I start? Well, 1973. Here comes the history bit, I brought this album about 1981 from the market, secondhand. If you saw my RAM review, you'd see that I had a toss up between what was the most stupid looking album cover, and I was going to buy the least stupid looking one, which in the end Ram one. Would you believe it? Anyway, let's crack on. Now we're going to start off here. This, I don't know if this is the correct sequence of the album tracks, but the sequence I've got here personally is the first track, and I could tell you it's pretty much downhill afterwards, aside from the bonus track or two. The first one is called My Love. Now, My Love is perfect track. It's slushy, sure, and you know, I bet John Lennon heard it and he thought, bleh, you know, and some people would think that, but if you're in love, you're thinking about your girl, and just listen to those words and listen to that. It's a beautiful guitar song. It's a beautiful song. I mean, it's perfect. It's I don't think it could have ever have been a Beatles track. So when these people say, ooh, in 50, 100 years time, lines will be blurred, there will be no Beatles and solo Beatles, it'll all be mixed up. It won't be. Believe you me, this is McCartney. This is McCartney doing what he does best. Now, you might have heard some of my video uploads and thought to yourself, ooh, all he does is run Paul McCartney down. No, I'm a critic. I'm critical, and I'm not crazy nerd. You know what I mean? I've got all the albums. I've listened to all the albums and I've made my judgment. Right, you got that? Anyway, so this one, My Love, it's got a 10. I mean, there's no two ways about it. Mess live at The Hague. It's all right. We give it a 2. So what? Then we're on the album proper, I believe. The Big On Bed. Sleeping in a big bum bed. It's fun, it's catchy, it's bollocks. It gets 2. 2 for you, alright? Next one. Get on the right thing. Get on the right thing. Get off my butthole. It's shit. 0. Nothing. Next, When the Night. Now, you know what I like about this song? It reminds me of Georgie Fame. I quite like Georgie Fame. He's got a distinctive voice. Baby loves me. He wants me off of my own. It sounds like Georgie Fame. Now, you know, sometimes Macca can sound like different people. He's even sounded like ABBA at some point. I'll get to that on another review, but yeah, I like it. I like it. I'm going to give it. It doesn't deserve any better than a 5. Let's be serious. It's all right. All right. Next one is called One More Kiss. Only one more kiss. I didn't mean to hurt you, girl. Only one more kiss. I didn't mean to hurt you, girl. For you, Sandra, I'm sorry. I'm sorry you come in and I sexually abused you. I hope you come back tomorrow. This is a personal plea. Nothing to do with this video. By the way, this song is not bad. It's all right. You know, it's what Macca does. It's a bit throwaway. It's harmless. It gets a 5. No. It gets a 6. It gets a 6. It's a bit above average. And the next one, oh, this is a controversial one. Dragonfly, fly by my window. Now I've heard some people singing its praises like it's Jerusalem or something. That is not. I mean, sometimes when you hear Paul McCartney songs and then you find out, you know, you think, no, that's not a bad song. Then you find out what the inspiration was, what it was about. That you think to yourself, fuck, now I've gone right off it. Now, the song Wanderlust from Tug of War, I didn't find out, but John Heaton, you know, the posh bloke, he's it was about a drugs bust, in the Caribbean. And I thought, oh my, please, you know, I thought it was about something. No, I never thought about it. But now I know it's about something pointless, stupid. And, you know, it makes the song pretty bad to me. You know, it makes it a bit more pointless and it detracts from good tune. And this is the same one. I mean, Little Lamb, Dragonfly. This could have been an anthem. It could have been. If he'd put some words to it, it's about a dead goat or something. God, you know, I've had a dead spider. I haven't written a song about it. Not a song as bad as this. You know, it's Denny Lane and Paul McCartney and they're singing the praises of a fucking boat. What is this, Noah's Ark? Christ, I mean, I've got no answer for you, little lad. No, I mean, I didn't even, when my dad died, I didn't even hang on as much as this. I say, for fuck's sake, Buster's left me 30 quid. That was what I said. But this is, I've got, what can I say? I don't know, I'm confused about this one. There's something good about it. There is something good about it, but I can't put my finger on it. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna give it a 4 because it's about a fucking goat.
Single pigeon through the railings, did she throw you out?
Single pigeon. On the other hand, it's a great song. I like it. It's a short song. And Macca does a good short song from time to time. You know, that, have you heard that one, Backwards Traveller? Hey, did you know that I'm going back time? It's great. It's a short song. And this one, though, it's a short song. And I like it. Especially when it says, Regent Park Canal. Do you need a pal for a minute or two? You do. Me too. Me too. Yeah. Anyway, I'm going to give this one, I'm going to give it a 7. Yeah. Why not? Luke, for the first Indian on the moon. Something I like about it, something, you know, I know he's trying to be funny and he's in a brick again, but something that works about this song, I'm not going to give it a higher mark than 3. Sorry, it is a pile of shit. Now we're on controversial territory. Now this is a medley, it ain't no Abbey Road medley, it's a pile of shit. I'm going to go through each track separately. Hold Me Tight. Not the one from with the Beatles. I'll give it a 3 for annoying catchiness.
Oh, will you find that feeling in your heart?
Lazy Dynamite. What's it about? Nothing. 0. 0 out of 10. I think the next one's called Hands of Love.
Falling into the hands of love.
Hands of Love. It's bollocks. It gets a 1 though. It gets a 1. I can't remember this. Oh, Power Cut. Now this is the age of the 3-day week, so I suppose he's trying to be contemporary. For those of you who don't know the 3-day week, look it up, Google it. It's shit, especially maybe I love you so, it's crap. 0 out of 10. Now we're on to the bonus tracks. Live and Let Die. Now George Martin produced this one. This is the single. It wasn't on the album, and it's a good James Bond film. It's a good theme. And somehow they've managed to pacify Linda's dreadful vocals. I don't know how they did it. It's kind of worked. It all worked. It's used a little bit too much now. I don't think the old fucker can sing it anymore. But yeah, here we are. I Lie Around. Crap. 0. Helen Wills. I've got to give a mention. This is another single, Helen Wills' Country Dreamer. This is fucking crap. I mean, Helen Wills was the name of his tour van. Another example. It's not even if I didn't know what the song was about, I'd still think it was shit. And another one of this bullshit, the B-side was Country Dreamer, and this is bullshit, just like, remember Heart of the Country from Ram? Same shit. Both of them get zero. In fact, for the first time ever, I'm going to give Helen Wills minus two degrees. That's unheard of so far. So bear that in mind. Right, okay, that's it. That's all I've got to say about this album. And I'll just mention the album cover. It's piss poor. It is piss poor. All right then, fellas and girls and Hail Caesar!